You know, many of my recent videos have involved games that have also come out rather recently. That's all well and good, but sometimes you want to sit back and peruse the vast library of games that were actually made before 2010. Experience a different age of gaming. And yes, that pun was quite intentional. For this video, I'll be taking you back to the ancient year of 2005. When Hollaback Girl was a number one hit, the Patriots won a Super Bowl, wait, no, that's not unusual. The San Antonio Spurs won the, no, that one is usual as well. Didn't any sports team unusually win in 2005? Oh, sweet Chicago White Sox, how far you have fallen. Anyway, where was I? Oh yes, 2005, when a new game came onto the market called Age of Empires 3. Age of Empires 3 is part of the real-time strategy series developed by Ensemble Studios and published by Microsoft Game Studios. It released on PC in 2005 and Mac in 2006, and that's pretty much it, platform-wise. Sorry, console gamers. Oh, unless you want the mobile version. Oh, wait, the mobile version was available for only Windows Mobile and something called Engage. Frankly, I never even knew these existed until researching this video. The game's time period is set through the colonization of the Americas from the 15th century to about the mid-19th century, which is portrayed in-game by advancing through the ages. Wow, a game that incorporates its title into its gameplay? Wonders never cease. Age of Empires 3 also had two expansion packs back when those were the common way to add content to games, called the War Chiefs and the Asian Dynasties, which added additional empires to the 8 originally playable ones and some new gameplay mechanics. Age of Empires 3 has two game modes, Skirmish and Campaign. Skirmishes can be done single-player against AI or multiplayer. You choose between the various empires of the game, choose a map, mainly from the Americas, and jump in. The empires to choose from in the base game are Britain, France, Spain, the Netherlands, Portugal, Germany, Russia, and the Ottomans. Basically, European colonial nations, plus the Ottomans. Amerindian tribes feature as groups that can be allied with depending on the map, but the War Chiefs added three fully playable tribes, the Iroquois, the Sioux, otherwise known as the Lakota, and the Aztecs. Asian Dynasties then added three Asian nations to play with as well, the Indians, Japanese, and Chinese. Each civilization has a unique playstyle, typically based around their special units and buildings. The Russians can overwhelm you with quickly produced but comparatively weak units, while the Ottomans specialize in heavy damage units such as janissaries and cannons. The nations are also balanced decently well, so you can certainly win with whatever nation you play. Although multiplayer may be different, I can't say though given my limited experience with it. Adapting your playstyle to fit your nation's advantages is the best way to gain an advantage while leading them to victory. Once you're into the game, you use your settlers to gather the three resources in-game. Food, which can be gathered from wild animals or berry bushes, wood, gathered of course from trees, and coin, which can be gathered from gold or silver deposits and from whales. Asian Dynasties adds export into the mix, which can be used with a consulate building to get units from the European nations of the game. Each civilization also starts out with an explorer, war chief, or monk who can walk around the map and gather treasures that grant more resources. These units cannot be killed, but can be incapacitated when they have taken enough damage. They can also build trading posts at native villages and along trade routes that can gain your civilization allies or resources. These tribes and trading posts are part of what makes these maps unique. The player needs to employ different tactics to succeed in each one. The resources gathered by settlers and explorers are used to build buildings, train and upgrade units, and advance through technological ages. The age advancement also gives bonuses depending on your choice of politician or wonder, which can be buildings, units, or cows, depending on your choice. The player also unlocks buildings depending on the age. For instance, the barracks needed to train units doesn't unlock until the second age, the colonial. Meanwhile, of course, your enemies are gathering resources as well to try and defeat you. You can set victory conditions, but the default way to win a skirmish is by destroying the other civilizations on the map. While you are struggling to build your society in the Americas, though, back home isn't turning its back on you. Age of Empires 3 has the home city mechanic, where once you get enough experience, you can receive shipments from your capital, whether that's Lisbon, Tenochtitlan, or Edo. For the Iroquois and Sioux, though, the home city is called the War Council, but it functions in the same way. These shipments can contain resources, settlers, buildings, and units. Some buildings, in fact, can only be gotten through these shipments, such as factories and forts. And like the buildings and units, certain shipments can only be gotten after you've advanced to a certain age. The choices of shipments that can be gotten is formed through a deck of shipments you can unlock as you level up your home city with the skirmishes played. There is a slight bit of base management then in ensuring you have the best shipments in your deck. All of this makes skirmishes a fun game mode with a lot of factors you can vary up to obtain a different style of game. The game also has a campaign, which for the base game and War Chiefs involves the Black Family across the ages and their fight against the Circle of Ossus, who want to find and control the Fountain of Youth. Asian Dynasties has its own separate campaign, but the general principle of what I'm going to say applies to both. The story is there. It's not anything special or that great, but it's okay. Certainly better than some campaign stories I've played. The main appeal of the campaign, though, is the gameplay. The scenarios and challenges are the best part of the campaign. The creative restrictions and enemies make the campaign a fun experience to play through. I also mean what I said when I said it has challenges, because on its hardest mode, the campaign can be quite difficult at times. In a good way, because the difficulty is generally not too taxing. Artistically, the character models and effects hold up reasonably well. The opening cutscenes being the one very dated looking part of the art style. Some animations are not as smooth as they would be now as well, but I'd say it adds to the charm of the game rather than taking away from the experience. One area that certainly aged well is the music, which is still as exciting and thrilling as it was at the time. Each piece of music fits the sense of exploration, discovery, and progression that fills every game of Age of Empires. I do think they could have done more to diversify the music for the expansions, but that's a minor grievance for such a well-composed soundtrack. The real-time strategy genre has certainly come down from its golden age when Age of Empires 3 was made, so it is good to know that those RTS games of the time still hold up well to this day. Age of Empires 3 is a fun, easy to get into, hard to master game that offers many hours of fun content for any type of player. The expansions included in the Steam version of the game add more play options without breaking the core experience, a problem some RTS games had. It is one of the premier RTS experiences available on Steam, coming from a studio that really knew what it was doing, coming off the also very popular Age of Empires 2. Until they finally come out with Age of Empires 4, though, this is a great alternative for scratching that early 2000s gaming era itch. Even if you never played games then, I recommend Age of Empires 3 as a fun game for almost any player. Hope you enjoyed the video. If you liked it, like it, and subscribe if you want to see more. Have a great day, and happy gaming.